that full court pressure now being put on by Piper. There's Gregory over there to DeBon. He's being guarded by Kerr. DeBon's having a good first quarter here.
Resetting the offense here.
My man Keach is in the game. That's Keach. He was balling last night. Got a shoe on the floor. DeBon for three off the mark. Rebound Gregory. Still a shoe on the floor. I can't tell whose it is.
It's number 15 for Piper. He just slipped.
McKenna. Jackson.
He could have made a play right there, but he kind of slipped whenever he went to jump in the lane and just nothing he could have done. Just had to stay on the ground.
McKenna's got half their points right now. He's got nine. It's 18-11. They tie those 7 points. Their second time they've been up by seven tonight. We've got 25 seconds to go here in the first quarter.
I wouldn't be surprised if Piper holds for the last shot here.
Moore, penetration. Grown man move doesn't finish. Rebounded by, and look at Moore.
He's just a pest.
Here comes McKenna. Penetration. Ooh, the sophomore just missed it. Keeps battles. Kerr battles. Moore batters. 2 seconds. Up the floor. Alamar Brooks on the battle down there. So 7-point lead. It's 18-11 after one. We'll be back here in 30 seconds. It's the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic here on Comet Vision.
Cut. Beautiful. Okay, let's go again.
Tell me about your vision.
At the end of the day, it's your classic coming of age story.
Get any more shipping labels?
All the gig speed, fiber-fueled internet you need to take whatever and make it big. Sparklight Internet, a stronger.
We are back here in Chanute, the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic. I'm DJ Dangerfield alongside Bryson Ginswider. Great job, Bryson, that first quarter, man.
Thank you. Veteran
over here. These kids know how to call these games. The story of the game right now is Max McKenna. He has 9 of the 18 points for Shawnee Mission South. And then you throw in DeBon, he has 6. So them two together, a lot of production coming from them for Shawnee Mission South.
And McKenna, he's only a sophomore.
Yeah, man, he's only a sophomore. He's gotten to his groove here in this first half.
Just imagine him 2 years from now.
Yeah, buddy.
Senior year.
No doubt about it. You got Moore. You got Alamar Brooks on the floor. You got Lance Walton on the floor. You got Thomas and my man Roth on the floor for Piper. Piper's in purple. Penetration by Walton off the mark. Rebound. There's a couple of misses down low by the guards for Piper. Walton, very capable player. He's been unable to make that one fall. On the floor from South is you got McKenna, you got Keach, you got Kerrigan, you got Gregory. All on the floor for them. And you got DeBon on the floor for Shawnee Mission South. They're wearing white. Look at Gregory with the little hook. Got away with the hook. Penetration. Spin move by Kerrigan. They're going to call a foul on Roth there. Spin cycle by Kerrigan.
And back to the line they go. Fourth or fifth time they've been to the line so far. Very aggressive down in the paint.
Yeah, Kerrigan last night late in the third quarter, in the fourth quarter against Chanute, he played some valuable minutes for Shawnee Mission South. His first basket, I believe.
Shooting one more for the Raiders, number 34, Connor Kerrigan.
Something that's been different about this game so far for Shawnee Mission South is they've only made one three-pointer so far.
Yeah, they're playing very solid basketball. Their largest lead of the game. They're up by 9 now. 7 minutes to go this half. DJ Moore now trying to turn the corner. They're unable to get the ball inside like they did last night.
Wow, great what save. A save.
Great save by Brooks. Moore now over to Roth. Roth with the three in the corner. It's off the mark. Rebounded by DeBon. He secured that rebound. Now you look, watch how Shawnee Mission South controls the tempo of the game. They run when they run a run. They're very patient when they want to be patient. DeBon spin cycle gets blocked.
They call.
And they're going to call a jump ball. That's the right call. It came down with a player where both players had their hands on the ball. That makes it a jump ball. Good help defense. You got Thomas and Kerr. That's a tough two to get the ball over. These two tough guys. Both of them can jump out the gym.
Going into this game, I was expecting Piper to be able to speed Shawnee Mission South up on the offensive end, but they've just been able to keep their tempo as they want it and be able to just get to their spots and put it in the basket. I mean, great defense right there.
Yeah. You're going to see them do that a lot as they will come out man-to-man. They'll start trapping in certain spots on the wing. Good job by Moore. Loose ball, and he's going to stay with Shawnee Mission South.
Smart play to not try to save that by Walton.
The key for Piper is to realize there's a lot of basketball left. So a lot of kids will panic. They'll scoreboard watch and panic. Basketball is a possession game, believe it or not, just like football. Good move. Good move by Max McKenna. He's now in the double digits. He has 11. That's a grown man move right there by the sophomore. Goodness gracious.
And I'm sure these kids are well aware that there is this time left. I mean, most of them are juniors and seniors. They've been here. And they have the ability to get back into this game.
Yeah, the awareness is mental toughness. Great shot in the corner, not knocked down, though, by number 24, DJ Thomas. Look at the pace of South. Look at that pace here. They're up by 11, their largest lead of the game, and they're taking their time. Gregory now being guarded by Lance Walton.
It's very easy to speed yourself up when playing against a team that plays aggressive defense, but they know how to stay disciplined and play the game how they want to play it and really dictate how this game goes.
Gregory being guarded by Walton there up front. Piper in the purple. Shawnee Mission South in the white. Shawnee Mission South is the home team. We got a timeout on the floor. That's a good timeout. That's a good timeout there. We'll take one with them. 30-second timeout. It's the 52nd Andy Ruffner Classic here on Common Vision.
KFEX 93.1 FM and Comet Vision are excited to partner with Dr. Grant Gastineau. Dr. Gastineau graduated from Chanute High School and is committed to supporting the activities of the youth of Chanute. Thank you, Dr. Gastineau. We appreciate your support.
Back here in Chanute, Kansas. My man Bryson next to me. We're in the first half here of the first game. Shawnee Mission South has an 11-point lead. They're largest lead of the game. Mainly because super sophomore Max McKenna getting his game on. He's got 11 tonight. He's playing a very good basketball game tonight. Just haven't had an answer for him. They're doing a great job on defense. I mean, we're almost halfway through this first quarter, and Piper hasn't scored yet.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, so just a great job. And Piper settled for a couple threes. They're not getting the ball in the middle of the floor like they did last night. They're not getting that high-low action going like they did last night. Shawnee Mission South is just taking all their strengths away from them. Great cut by McKenna. Off the glass, no good. He somehow comes up with the offensive rebound because of Kerrigan. And there's Keats. That's my man right there. That's my boy right there. Brett Keats gets on the board for the first time tonight. I love it. I love players like Keats, man. Largest lead now, 13-point lead.
Number 15, Darren Jackson.
Here's Jackson. Down the lane, tough shot.
One thing
no call.
Shawnee Mission South has done very well is, although they are – I would say probably the shorter team, less athletic team. They've been able to get on the boards after they force misses on the defensive end, and they've even gotten on the boards on the offensive end.
That foul down there was on Kerrigan. He got called for the reach. McKenna's going to have a seat. Boy, hey, great first half. And Featherston comes in for him.
He has the same amount of points as the other team has.
Yes, he's balling out there. Super soft. There's Moore. He's being guarded by Gregory. No, by Featherston. Moore gets into the lane. That's what you want to see him do. There's Thomas.
Has the height advantage, but.
Call the foul here.
That was a mismatch they wanted. I don't know if they really wanted that foul to be called there.
I don't know. Okay, he's calling Featherston. Featherston with the arm in the back.
Second team foul.
Now the Rick. Coaches want an explanation. I love it. Neither one of these coaches have had a player foul anybody tonight. That's why I love it. That's my favorite part. It's my favorite part of the game. Moore gets it blocked, and they're going to call a foul. Call a push. So that'll get more to the line.
You could hear one of the Piper coaches yelling, great call right
there. I didn't know if that was a fan or a coach. I couldn't tell.
It's great. It's great when it's for them. It's not great when it's against
them.
So Moore's going to get the shoot, too. And that's something you were talking about earlier. We haven't seen them shoot a lot of free throws. And when they did shoot, they missed both of them.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe Moore can get on the board here for the first time in the second quarter.
I mean, I think they really just need to see it go in the basket, build up some momentum.
Yeah, they haven't scored yet in this quarter. Right now, it's a 6-0 lead in this quarter by Shawnee Mission South.
I think once they see that ball go in, they can get a little bit of confidence and maybe be able to claw themselves back into this game to end this first half.
Sauter came into the ball game for DeBon. Moore makes the first free throw of the game for the Pirates. His first point of the quarter and the first point of this quarter for the Pirates.
Very cut aggressive it to 12. Press here.
Here's Gregory now. He's being guarded by Moore. Piper stays in their man-to-man defense. Don't be surprised you see a trap here every once in a while and it gets to that wing. Jackson guarding Keach. Keach penetrates baseline, kicks out to Featherston in the corner for three. Just up, but tipped in by Kerrigan. And I told you last night, Kerrigan was big down the straight defensively for Shawnee Mission South, and that's what he does. He hangs around the basket, makes things happen. Kerrigan's just a freshman, FYI.
Wow.
Long three by Lance Walton. He's probably the best shooter on their team. He had two or three threes last night. Ooh, Moore with great D. Oh, they're going to call a foul on him. I thought that was good defense that time. And the coach is not happy. He is not happy. And I thought that was – I have to defer to the coach on this one. I thought that was pretty good D. Moore's got two now. There's Gregory now being guarded by Moore. Going inside to Keach. Look at Keach, man. Look at Keach. Oh, he's – tough shot. He tried to go underneath and reverse it. And there's Kerr. Oh, he faked it. He traveled. Yeah.
Travel.
I don't know why he didn't just go up with that.
He would have went up strong and most likely would have got fouled there.
Yeah, he should have punched that. I was looking for something. I throw that thing down.
I thought there's about to be some fireworks.
Yeah. Alamar Brooks comes in for P.J. Moore because he has two fouls. 2:50 to go here in the half. That's Sauter that was bringing up. It gets over to Gregory now. Still in that man-to-man defense. If you're just now tuned in, great ball game being played in Shawnee Mission South. Look at Keach with the penetration. Shawnee Mission South is in the white. There's Sauter. Pull-up jumper, and it's good. His first basket by the junior. Now 13-point lead, largest lead of the ball game for Shawnee Mission South. Great drive, man. Great drive by Lance Walton.
Lance Walton is very good at penetrating, mm-hmm. and then he has incredible vision, and he's able to kick it out, find someone in the corner, find someone on the block, and they can just put it in for an easy bucket.
Keach has a seat. Max McKenna comes in. Great minutes by Keach. That's probably my favorite player of the tournament right now. I love a guy that can come off the bench and provide a spark. He does just that. Jackson spins, gives it up to Thomas. Thomas blocked by Sauter. Down the floor they come. Featherston to McKenna. McKenna goes up strong. He's going to be fouled by Alamar Brooks.
Down here on the other side, it seemed like the whole gym wanted it to be a carry right there.
I didn't know. I just happened to turn my head to look at the clock, so I didn't see if it was a travel or a carry. I didn't know for sure what they were fired up about. Max McKenna's going to go to the line. He has one free throw already. Go along with his 11 points. Super soft. Coming out. Asserting himself in this ball game. Getting to the 2-minute mark now. Shawnee Mission South now up by 14, their largest lead of the half. There's Thomas being guarded by Kerrigan. Cross court pass. To Moore, he's being guarded by Featherston, and that'd be a foul on him. That was Brooks, excuse me, on the far side. We're having one of those games where nobody likes any call.
Yeah.
Nobody agrees with any call.
No matter what the refs
do. Yeah, buddy.
It's not right.
Shooting two
from
Shoot two here now is Alamar Brooks, the sophomore. He's going to shoot two of them. Front end. He hits that front end. A little more leg. A little more legs there. If I'm Kerr, I'm trying to sneak in there and get a tip here. Try getting on the freshman, take advantage of this freshman. Try that.
Looks like we have Ben Allen checking in for Featherston.
Featherston picks up a couple fouls, so they get Ben Allen in the ball game. There's McKenna under the pressure. Great steal. Kerr with the tip. And then the shot. Come on, Kerr. Battle.
Oh.
That's a tough turnaround there. Lance Walton has missed a couple of shots down low near the basket, a couple of bunnies. Roth is now going to check in. And he comes in for Kerr.
Who just picked up his second foul right there. Both teams are very close to the bonus here.
Yeah, we're shooting the rest of this quarter.
I think Shawnee Mission might already be in the bonus.
Yeah, we're shooting the rest of this quarter. Both teams will be shooting the rest of this quarter. Brooks trying to hassle McKenna. McKenna wow. Able to make a tough finish. He's having quite the half. Long three by Jackson, and it's good. His first three of the tournament. 31-19 now. Oh, almost stolen. Almost stolen. By Walt. Just missed it. There's Gregory. Goes inside of Sauter. Ooh, Sauter almost traveled with it.
Oh.
Turnover there.
Great pass thrown right ahead. Led him perfectly, but
missed
the layup
by Walton.
Just missed.
That's Walton's fourth miss down there. He is struggling finishing here in this first quarter. There's Kerrigan out to McKenna on the baseline there over Roth. Misses it. Kerrigan battles. Gets the rebound. Goes up on Thomas. Throws up a wild shot, gets his own rebound, puts it up and in. And the freshman, he has six in this half. Six in this quarter, actually, and it's 33-19.
They just keep fighting on the boards.
Yeah, right now they are destroying them on the boards. Way too many opportunities. Jackson with a back-to-back threes. It's good.
He's feeling it now.
And that's the sophomore. He did a heat check. He knocks it down, brings it back to 11. 5 seconds to go. Allen shoots his own three, traveled. Yep, he traveled.
Nailed it, but he traveled.
Yep, he traveled. Unfortunate, but he did. He's just there's a lot of young guys. Ben Allen's just a sophomore. There's some young cats on the floor.
That's one of my favorite shots in the game right there. A little hezzy pull-up three. Yeah. Kevin Durant is one that is very great
buddy,
at that.
You ain't lying about that. Paul George comes to mind, too. Here comes Jackson. Another heat check from the same spot. Just a little short. So Jackson provides some life for Piper in the first half down the stretch. But, man, Shawnee Mission South poured it on there. They scored 15 in that quarter. Looks like Piper scored 11 in that quarter, so they won that by four. And I think Piper waited too long.
Mm-hmm. Those two threes, though, I think are huge to build onto the momentum going into this second half.
I agree with you. I do agree with you on that. So you want to come back here in a little bit, right?
Yeah.
Second half. One more thing you want to say?
They cut the lead down from around 15, 14 to 11, and that's huge, really, when you think about it. And
yep.
I think there's – don't go home yet. There's
no.
a great
Look,
game.
Could you
going.
Imagine if Jackson would have hit that three right there? I think he did it. There's still things to build on. They're not. They got simple things to fix. Rebound the ball. Mm-hmm. Let's see if we can't get the ball in the middle of the floor, work our high-low action. We got to figure out how to get – Kerr and Thomas involved. Kerr only has two. Thomas only has four. And then we got to figure out how to get Lance Walton and P.J. Moore to finish.
Mm-hmm.
Them two guards, they're exceptional players.
I think the game might be tied if it wasn't for those missed bunnies just right under the basket.
Absolutely. So, listen, folks, if you're not on your way out here, you want to be on your way out here. If you're not, if you're staying and watching home, you want to keep it locked here to Comet Vision. It's the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic here. Good ball game between the Shawnee Mission South Raiders And the Piper Pirates.
Yep.
I was messing that all up yesterday. I couldn't figure out. I didn't know if we was playing Pittsburgh. All I saw was purple. I didn't know what was going on. So we'll more come out in the second half. Thank you for being tuned in.
Cardinal Drugstore, located at 103 East Main in downtown Chanute, is a small-town pharmacy and gift store which includes an old-fashioned soda fountain. They specialize in compounds and vaccines. They also supply many types of medical items. Cardinal Drugstore is your one-stop shop for all of your healthcare needs. KFEX and Comet Vision are so grateful for your support. From kickoff to the final lap, from peewees to the weekend pros. Our team of doctors can help with the diagnosis and treatment of sports-related injuries. Wherever you are in your sports journey, Labette Health Sports Medicine Team has the training, experience, and skill to repair, restore, and renew. For more information about Southeast Kansas' leading orthopedic and sports medicine program, go to labettehealth.com.
The Medicine Shop Pharmacy, located right across the street from Royster Middle School in downtown Chanute, is in the business of making you feel better, faster. With three licensed pharmacists, the Medicine Shop has the knowledge to know the right drugs and the proper dosage to ensure your safety. If you're not quite up to your game, Medicine Shop offers delivery to your door. The Medicine Shop, a proud underwriter of the Chanute Blue Comets.
Unbelievable! Sparklight is unveiling unlimited internet for just $25 a month. Get reliable 100 meg internet for just $25 a month for 12 months with unlimited data. That's unlimited internet. Call 877-469-3057 or visit sparklight.com/savings. Sparklight, a new breed in high speed.
We're back here in the second half here at the 52nd Annual Ralph Miller Classic, the very first game. For the Piper Pirates are taking on the Shawnee Mission South Raiders, and the Raiders right now lead it 33-22. Now, they're going to be ran white, and the Pirates will be ran their purple. And I tell you what, Connor Kerrigan scored 6 of the 15 points that Shawnee Mission South. So Kerrigan came out from off the bench and was a spark in that second quarter for the Raiders. And then a spark for the Pirates. Derek Jackson scored 6 of the 11 points scored in that quarter. He was a spark for the Pirates. And last night he only had 2, and so him getting 6 is a big deal coming through here for them as a starter. We haven't seen much, though, off the bench. Alamar Brooks did make a free throw off the bench for them. Gannon Roth missed a 3. He shot, so there's not been very much bench support. And interesting enough, Johnny Vogel played a lot last night. Johnny Vogel did. He had a 3 last night. Played a really good ball game, but we haven't seen him here in the second half. He's number 4 for the Piper Pirates, and so we haven't seen him. It'll be interesting. So it looks like Kerr and Jackson and Moore and Thomas and Walton on the floor for the Pirates, and for Shawnee Mission South, it's going to be McKenna, Gregory, Sauter, Devon, and Featherston. Here we go, folks. Beginning of the second half, Piper has their work cut out for them, down by 11. Man-to-man defense by Shawnee Mission South. That's Jackson. He's feeling it. He hits another one. That's his 3rd one. He's going to start the 3rd quarter off the way he left the 2nd. And that's 9 points in a row for Jackson. And so it's probably now time to get out on him. He's feeling himself right now. There's DeBond now down the middle of the lane. Good defense by Jackson. Made a tough shot. He spins out of the pressure. And Jackson is feeling himself. Finds Walton in the corner for 3.
Bang.
And there it is. His 2nd one of the night. He has 8. Timeout on the floor. They've cut it to 5. And the Pirates are motivated. We'll take a 30-second break. We'll be right back. We got a good game brewing here. 33-28. It's the 52nd Annual Ralph Miller Classic here on Comet Vision.
Home Savings Bank is a platinum underwriter here at the Fire Escape Coffee House. Home Savings Bank has been serving the Chanute area since 1886. Customer-owned and customer-driven, Home Savings Bank, located at 214 North Lincoln Avenue in Chanute, Kansas, is here to serve all your banking needs. Whether your needs are checking, savings account, safety deposit box, lending, or online banking, Home Savings Bank is here to help. Home Savings Bank is located on the internet at homesavingschanute.com. Home Savings Bank is committed to the youth of Southeast Kansas and helping the ministries at the Fire Escape Coffee.
We're back, and just like that, I got Bryson Ginswider sitting next to me. I'm DJ Dangerfield, and just like that, it's a 5-point game. Pirates pressure.
It feels like if you blink for 1 second, it goes from an 11-point game to now a 5-point game.
You got Derek Jackson, he busts a 3. And then Lance Walton knocks down a 3.
Derek Jackson gets the assist there, too.
Yeah, absolutely. Yep.
That 3.
Good call. I don't know how he got out of there.
Mm-hmm.
He spun out of the pressure somehow.
Did like a 720 and then got out of there.
And it was cool the whole time. I mean, it was like no big deal. It was like, this is what I do.
Mm-hmm.
Here's Gregory up front being guarded by Walton.
This has been a game.
Featherston being guarded by Jackson.
Game by the young people. I mean, Derek Jackson is a sophomore.
Great drive by Sauter.
Derek Jackson is a sophomore, and Kerrigan is a freshman. McKenna is a sophomore. Those for Shawnee Mission South, and they've all had huge games here.
Inside to Kerr. He gets a little contact, unable to finish. Great look. P.J. Moore on the cutting. Devin Kerr. He didn't score in the 2nd quarter. That's a big deal. That's a big deal. Fouls on Max McKenna. That's his 2nd. But Kerr didn't get on the board that last quarter. That's not like him. We've got to figure out how to get these posts involved. You've got to figure out how to get Thomas and Kerr involved. They're a very key point to this offense, and they just haven't been able to get them the ball.
Although the threes have got them back into this game, you cannot just 100% rely on the threes to
Absolutely.
Win this game. You need to get the dirty buckets down low.
Absolutely.
In order to win.
Gregory being guarded by Walton. You got McKenna being guarded by Moore. McKenna turns on the baseline. Out to Featherston for three. Bam! Featherston's second three of the night. Extends the lead to 8 points. That's the second three for the team. Featherston has both of them. And now a little pressure on Jackson. He turns the corner so easy. Look how easy he makes that look. My goodness, he makes that. Ooh, turnover. First one of this half. Seventh of the ball game. That time, Lance Walton a little too unselfish. Did a little trap there on McKenna. Jackson and Walton.
What a find.
Over to Gregory for three. Off the mark. Battle for the board. Pulled down by Kerr. Here comes Jackson. Looking up the floor. He dribbles high, too. It's a high dribble. But, boy, I know he knows how to handle that ball.
Very, very shifty dribbler.
Thomas in the corner. No good. Battle for loose ball. Picked up by. Ooh, wow. Good job. Oh, man. Kerr misses down low. Gets his own rebound.
It seems game plan going into the second half is just get Jackson the ball. Get Derrick Jackson the ball and let him work the offense.
Moore did a good job keeping that ball going and was able to get, ooh, long three by Gregory. Battle for the loose ball, bodies everywhere.
Jump ball called.
Let's call it jump ball. DeBond felt like he was fouled. A lot of contact down there, let go. 6-point lead here, 5 minutes to go in the third quarter.
You can kind of just sense a new energy from the Piper Pirates this second half starting out. They feel much more – they're just energized by
downtown.
The offense they've been playing.
Featherston from Waytown. Great save
by
McKenna to Sauter. Sauter finishes it, and that's six for him. He has four in this quarter. Look at that. They're called a legal screen on Kerr. I think that's his third. Roth is going to come in for Thomas.
Still have yet to see Johnny Vogel.
Yeah, that kind of shocked. He got a lot of playing time. But I guess if Jackson's going to play like this, I guess you just got to rotate.
I mean, it makes you think he might be.
Because we didn't see Brooks. I don't remember seeing Brooks last night. I may have missed him. There's DeBond. Kerr got caught on the front side. Oh, DeBond with a tough miss down low. He's going to stay here.
I think we need to get this basket checked out. All the layups have been missed down here.
No doubt. Kerr got caught on the top side there. Great seal by DeBond. He just unable to finish.
Beautiful pump fake to get him in the air. Just missed it.
Featherston. This is a shot there on the baseline. Jackson was the one guarding that shot. Here comes Moore. He's quick. He can finish, too. That might be a charge, yep. That is a charge. He was there for a little bit. He had his camping equipment. He pitched a tent. Started grilling. He was there for a little bit. Good
Making
call.
Making some s'mores.
Good call by the young official. We got Alamar Brooks now checking in. And we got DJ Thomas checking in.
And I would expect coming down at the end of this third quarter for a lot of pressure and a lot of press going on for the Piper.
Moore and Kerr have three fouls. We want to pay attention to that. Those are two assets for the Pirates. And they have to sit down because they both have three. There's DeBond working against Thomas, getting whatever shot he wanted. And that time, it wasn't footwork. He bullied his way into the paint and drew the foul.
And that's why you don't want Kerr getting into the foul trouble.
Man, great awareness by DeBond.
Knocks down the first.
Well, I tell you what. Shawnee Mission South was up for this game. They went to bed on time, got up, ate some good breakfast, then they walked through and they were ready for this game. Here comes Brooks quickly.
Very quick.
Brooks quickly. He's pushed out of bounds. Looks like he's going to be on Featherston.
I mean, that's a dangerous player. Someone that is that fast but also has control.
That's three for Featherston now. He has both threes for this team. Let's keep an eye on that. But my man Keach now, he can play. That's my dog right there. Keach can play this game. Checks into the ball game for Featherston. He's going to have to play some valuable minutes here. 3:45 to go.
The two super sophomores going at it right here. There's an off-ball foul called.
Foul is charged to Brett Keach, his first personal foul.
Keach gets called for foul. Of course, Keach disagrees.
That's just how it's going. But if you look at this matchup, we have Derek Jackson being guarded by McKenna.
Yeah, buddy.
The two super sophomores.
Yeah, buddy.
Key part of keeping this game how it is.
I love watching this Walton and this Gregory getting on. Inside to Thomas. He does a little shuffle shot, misses that, and Sauter pulls down the rebound. Trying to make some shots. Definitely winning the game on the boards here. I'm not tracking rebounds, but the eye test, they definitely are.
It checks out.
50-50 balls and rebounds. Trying to make some South is making sure they get those. McKenna now goes inside the bond. That's where I would go.
It just
good
seems
cut
like,
by Keach.
Seems like Shawnee Mission and South are always in the right place at the right time to get those loose balls.
There's DeBond for a long three. Off the mark. Oh. Rebound by Walton, and he's going to be fouled by Gregory. And that might be his third now. This is going to get interesting on his second. This is going to get, as the foul trouble comes on, this is going to get interesting. It's a 9-point lead. 255.
For both teams have gotten into relatively a little bit of foul trouble.
This bench is, both these teams' bench play is going to become big here down the stretch. Here's Jackson now. They're getting out on him for sure.
And they,
ooh, turnover. Second one of this half.
And he double dribble call.
Oh, they call double dribble on DeBond.
Can we get a replay on that? I don't think he dribbled the ball. Coaches certainly don't think he double dribbled.
I didn't see for sure.
I'm not
quite
sure.
These are two veteran officials. I mean, they've played enough basketball. They've done enough games. Sometimes you got to develop a trust with these guys. Long three for Brooks, and he knocks it down. Brooks has four. Cuts the lead to six. And Pirates are just hanging around, folks. This is brewing out to be a good game. That pressure's now coming on. Here comes McKenna. He likes the open floor. Oh, good job by Brooks. Calling for the reach.
I mean, I told everyone to stick around. This game's going to be good.
It is definitely that.
This game is still up in the air. 2 minutes left in this third quarter.
Shawnee Mission South underneath their own basket here. You got Keach. You got DeBond, you got Sauter, and you got McKenna on the floor. Gregory inbounding for Shawnee Mission South. You got Roth, you got Brooks, you got Jackson, you got Walton. Great move by DeBond on Roth.
That's a grown man
move. Oh, man. Listen, what I like about DeBond, he got a little swag to him.
Mm-hmm.
He got a little swag to him. Yeah, he's standing on business here in this third quarter. He's got nine, and this will get him into double digits. And he had a good second half last night.
One, good.
He scored 13. He's got 10 now. There's Jackson with penetration on McKenna. He grabs it and one. And the young man, Jackson, comes down. Yeah, man. And now Jackson has double digits, the sophomore. And he has a chance to get three the old-fashioned way. And that's three on McKenna. So this is going to get interesting here. Kerrigan checks in for Sauter. This is going to get interesting, folks. See how these benches do. Some key players got to get some key things done. And right now we're seeing Jackson just carry the Pirates. Ooh, great job by Keach in front of Brooks here. Good job by Keach.
Not let him get the block.
Good job by Keach. 8-point lead now. Sign of Mission South. Jackson plays with it. Shoots a long three off the mark. Rebound to Bond. Look how Kerrigan just grabs it, dribbles. A freshman. Kerrigan. Look how he just as a freshman, just grabs it, dribbles it. Takes off.
He's not afraid of anything.
No, extends the lead to 10 now here in the third. Just when you thought the Pirates were going to bid this huge comeback, Shawnee Mission South shuts it down. Jackson goes up on Keach. We call a block. It's actually the right call.
although no one in here agrees with it. But
well, the Pirates do. The Pirates agree with it.
The Pirates agree with it.
Yeah.
Two shots.
Yep, he was moving.
Yep.
For Derek Jackson,
just didn't want to, you got to let that contact come. You got to let that contact come. I'm going to make you earn the charge. When I officiate, I'm not giving you a charge. So if you start falling before the contact comes, I'm calling the block every time.
You got to lay it out there with no fear. Let them hit you.
In and out for Jackson. Rebound Kerrigan. It's a 9-point lead here. The Shawnee Mission South. They're in the white if you're watching at home. Just now tuned in. Pirates are in purple. Here's Keach. Being guarded by Roth. He penetrates, tries to go by him, up over him. No good. Battle by Kerrigan. Off the glass. Good. He's a key factor here. He has 10, the freshman. And that's the second time we've seen him get it off the offensive rebound. Here's Thomas. Kerrigan guarding him. And that's the thing he did last night in the second half. Kerrigan came off the bench and did a great job guarding down low. He's doing it again tonight. And here he is in the double. Look at the freshman out front there. Keach and Kerrigan.
Oh.
Oh, boy. Roth unable to make the catch from Thomas. We're down to 28 seconds here in the third quarter. 11-point lead. Featherston comes into the game. He's coming in for Kerrigan. Great minutes by Kerrigan again. The last two quarters, Kerrigan scored all his last 2 points, all of his points in the last two quarters.
All almost stolen.
Oh, man, great it. Come up with it by Featherston. Good hustle by Moore. Just unable to come away with it. 20 seconds now. Look at DeBond. Spin cycle. Off the glass. Good. Look at him in the and one, Yale.
He's got the power and he's got the finesse.
DeBond. Check him out. Spin cycle. A little contact.
Plus one.
Yeah, man.
Let him know it.
Yeah, man. Off the window. Off the glass. Yes. Yes. He's our Windex player right now. He's using that glass eloquently out here. He's just using that glass, keeping it clean. He's rebounding the ball. Ooh, Thomas. Ooh, travel call. This may get him a technical. This might. The coach may. It's a 13-point lead.
14 seconds left.
Right now, 4 turnovers in this quarter. 10 turnovers for the game for the Pirates. It's back to 13. They've cut it to 6. To 5 at one point even.
Mm-hmm.
Here's Sada. Ooh, a little push by Thomas on DeBond. He's straight pushing down there. Keach for 3. He can hit that. Ooh, just missed it. Rebound by Jackson. And here we go. It's a 13-point game. Going into the fourth, but you see belts on. It's the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic here in Chanute, Kansas. Take a 30-second timeout. We'll be right back with some more basketball on Comet Vision.
Missing that human touch at your bank? At Community National Bank and Trust, you'll be able to talk with a real person. Community National Bank is small enough to know you, yet big enough to offer the best products. Your busy lifestyle requires banking options like mobile deposit and people-to-people pay. With locations in Southeast Kansas and Southwest Missouri, Community National Bank and Trust can help keep your finances safe and your spending smarter. Online at mybankcnb.com. Community National Bank and Trust. Federally insured. Locally awesome. Member FDIC.
Back here in Chanute, Kansas, being entertained by the Shawnee Mission South Raiders cheerleaders. They were just singing for us. Great third quarter by Shawnee Mission South. They won that one 19-17. So, again, that's probably the best quarter for the Piper Pirates, but it was nowhere near enough.
At the end of the day, they still lost the quarter.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
And they have a tough uphill climb they got coming here.
Shawnee Mission South, very disciplined. Very disciplined ball club. Hats off to Kerrigan and DeBond in that quarter. My goodness. Max McKenna had 14 in the first half. He hasn't scored here in the second half yet. But he didn't need to because DeBond and Kerrigan carried the team.
Mm-hmm.
On the floor. You see Kerr catches it. He's going to kick out to Jackson. Jackson with a long three. Ooh, just misses. Rebound Gregory. So on the floor for Shawnee Mission South, Gregory That's Sauter with the ball there. You got Featherston out there, Devon out there, and Kerrigan out there. For the Pirates, you got Walton, you got Moore, you got Thomas, you got Kerr, you got Jackson. And he gets a steal there. Jackson with the layup off the glass, no good, but followed up by Kerr.
Almost put back dunk.
Oh, yeah,
right, he
can do that too. He caught one off the glass last night and threw it down. He can jump. They're trying to get some more pressure on Sauter here. They're going to have a timeout on the floor.
A lot more aggressive.
And it's going to be a timeout for Shawnee Mission South, a 30-second timeout. We'll take a 30-second timeout. 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic here on Comet Vision.
KFEX Firescape Radio programming is made possible in part by the underwriting efforts of Sonic Drive-In of Chanute. Sonic Drive-In of Chanute does not consider community involvement a sales gimmick or a public relations ploy. They see it as a way to be a good neighbor and as a way to have a positive impact on their community. It is for these reasons that Sonic Drive-In of Chanute is a proud underwriter of KFEX Firescape Radio and the ministry efforts of the entire Firescape ministry to the youth of Chanute.
We're back here in Chanute, a very inspirational message by the coach from Piper. He was trying to inspire his players there. See how they respond. 7:15 if you're watching at home, fourth quarter. Shawnee Mission South has pretty much led this whole game. No point has it seemed like the Pirates have had control of this game. So they're going to have to go on a run here. Sauter just too strong down low. Oh, they called a travel. Wow. They called a travel.
It's quite a late call there, but.
Man, goodness gracious. 52-41, 7 minutes to go here in the game. Here's Jackson. Turns the corner, goes down here, misses another layup. Moore, though, down low. Tough layup. He scores it, and he hasn't scored since the second quarter. He's been so quiet. He's got foul trouble going on. He had to sit for a long time in that third quarter.
We know they're down, but not out. They cut it all the way down to six at one point.
Kerrigan tries to stay with it.
They have the ability to win this game still.
Moore spin cycles it. Gets some contact. He's going to shoot two. Moore only has 5 points tonight. After scoring 19 last night.
Two shots for the Pirates number three, B.J. Moore.
Just a good job by the guards of Shawnee Mission South, making his life a little difficult. McKeith's coming to the ball game for Sauter and Kerrigan. And right now, the bench play of Shawnee Mission South is really coming through.
What's in the second free throw?
Pressure by the Pirates, trying to get some extra possessions here. Keats battling. Here's Featherston. Gets it over to him. Ooh-wee. That's a turnover, yeah. Max McKenna that time went baseline.
7-point game.
Yeah, man, quietly a 7-point game. And the sophomores are going to see what sophomores are going to see. Ooh, whoa. Great dime.
Incredible
great
pass.
Great dime.
From the man that got them here in the first place.
Jackson with the great dime. Ooh, look at that. Gregory up the court pass there.
No need to
rush
it.
Walton get a Jake. Ooh, Keith with a tough three. That's a tough three early in the possession. And he played right in the Pirates' hand there. Moore now at the crossover. Looks insane. Oh, great pass by Moore. And Kerr's the recipient of that.
Down to a 3-point game, ladies and gentlemen. The closest it's been since the tip-off, it feels like.
It is. That's exactly. It hasn't been this close since the first quarter. You're exactly right. 52-49. They're going to call a foul on Jackson.
Called.
Just when the officials were letting them play a little bit, got a little exciting. First team foul this quarter.
There's Jackson Jr. Picks up his first personal foul.
That's his first foul here.
Team foul number one.
Shawnee South looking for their first basket.
Stole again. Gets it up to Jackson.
That's their fifth turnover here in the half. Jackson with the layup.
1-point game. Timeout is called. Ladies and gentlemen, get excited because when we come back, we got a great game ahead of us. 5 minutes left, one-point game.
Yes, sir, 30-second break. We'll be right back here at the 52nd Annual Ralph Miller Classic here on Comet Vision.
Headquartered in Fredonia, Ehlert Construction Services was founded in Southeast Kansas as a small regional contractor and has now grown into a national heavy industrial construction company with regional offices across the United States. The Ehlert family is proud of our Southeast Kansas roots because we know that the people of Southeast Kansas make great employees. At Ehlert, we know that employees are our greatest asset, and we're committed to investing in the growth of our employees and our community. Ehlert Construction Services, proud to support the youth of Southeast Kansas through the Firescape Coffee House and KFEX Firescape Radio.
We're back here in Chanute, 52nd Annual Ralph Miller Classic, very first game tonight, and we're watching the Piper Pirates on a 12-0 run. They were down by 13 to start this quarter, and with this full court pressure, they've cut it to one here in Chanute. Wow.
I knew it was coming eventually. And they have made this game incredible.
Derek Jackson leading the way here. And Kerr has been the recipient of some great passing by Morin Jackson. He has six in this quarter. And what a great start of the quarter if you're a Pirates fan. Here we go, folks.
I mean, if this isn't entertaining, I couldn't tell you what is.
Keach, Sauter, Debon, Featherston.
That's a trap.
Gregory on the floor for Shawnee Mission South. In white, Featherston, no good. Rebound Jackson. He's looking up the floor, possibly can take the lead. Over to Walton. He faked the three, gets it to Kerr. Walton thought about it. He thought about it. He has two tonight. He's probably the best pure shooter on this team, but Jackson has been the man tonight, the sophomore. Here's Moore, crossover against Gregory. Goes up, gets fouled by Debon. And they have the possibility of taking the lead for the first time in the game with 4:49 to go in the fourth quarter.
I mean, at times earlier in the game, especially in that second quarter, it seemed like they were out of it. But Derek Jackson hitting those two huge threes at the end of the first half, I knew it would amount to something.
Yeah. Debon has three fouls now. And so Moore needs one of these, man. He wants to tie this game. He has four in this quarter so far. He's really picked up. He missed both of them. That's tough. Rebounded by Sauter.
You need the free
Brooks
throw.
Is staying on him. There's Kerr now working against Debon. Debon said, get out of there. Debon wants to look at Brooks. Oh, ooh. 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 Second team foul.
Damon Kerr, number 12. It's his third personal foul.
He has
foul.
That's Kerr's fourth. That's a big deal. That's tough. Oh, boy, that's tough.
With a game like this, I would like to see the refs let him play a little bit more.
I tell you what, I'm with you, bro. I don't want to be too critical. Look at Jackson. Now, that was more of a foul than
I thought.
Goodness gracious.
That looked like a
no call again
right there.
Now, it's getting wild here. There's Jackson fakes the three on the baseline. Oh, turnover Jackson.
Bowling.
12 turnovers now in the game, 6.5 for the Pirates. One-point game, folks, if you're watching at home. Keach spins.
What a save. Stolen.
Another stall. Jackson draws the foul on Debon.
You can see Kerr wanted that off the backboard.
Yeah, he did. You see him pointing up? Yeah. Jackson said, no, cuz I got this.
He wanted to throw that down. Momentum
Jackson
slam.
Said, no, cuz I don't know if I can throw that pass. I know I can get to this rim. I don't know if I can throw that pass. Now, Debon's got four. So now you got Kerr and Debon with four. This is going to get interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Two shots.
This is going to get interesting.
Two, arguably the two most important players on the court right now.
Tie. We haven't had a tie game since we did the jump ball. And Jackson ties it up.
Looking to take the lead with the second one.
He has 16 tonight. And he gives them the first lead
of the entire game. They've trailed for 20.
Yes, 17. Ooh, great job by Sauter. Kerrigan blocked by Moore. Moore got up in the elevator and swatted it off the glass.
goodness.
Moore took an elevator up, went to the fifth floor, and swatted Kerrigan's shot off the glass. We have a conversation here.
Whoa.
And there's a controversy of whether or not the possession arrow is correct. The jump ball is correct. The score table is the one who gets to decide this. This is a
Piper was trailing this game for 28 minutes.
It'll be a white ball here. It'll be a white ball. Yes, man. 3:47 to go here in the fourth. And Pirates have somehow taken this lead. Only they – it's 3:47 to go. And Shawnee South has not scored yet. They have not scored yet in this fourth quarter.
No, they indeed haven't.
Gregory to Keach. Keach looks inside. Man-to-man defense being played here.
Very aggressive and
yeah, they're switching.
Jittery defense.
They're
here.
Switching screen. Ooh, Gregory. Ooh, wow. Gregory, it's a tough and one.
No.
Listen here, folks.
Piper thinks they're.
Listen here, folks. That is the first basket of the ball game for Gregory. It couldn't have came at a better time.
Piper was thinking that there was some offensive interference.
I don't think there was.
I don't think there was.
I don't think there was either.
I think he got his hand back.
I don't think there was any interference on it.
But now the third lead change.
It looked like it. It was not a smart play. It was not a smart play by Sauter. You don't do that.
No, you don't.
You don't do that. But nevertheless, the refs made the right call. And, boy, three, the old-fashioned way, it couldn't have come at a better time. That's the first basket of the quarter for Shawnee Mission South to give them the lead up by two. They once had a 13-point lead going into this quarter. There's Jackson being guarded by Kerrigan. He penetrates, shoots over Kerrigan. Off the mark, rebounded by Kerr. Kerr turns, kicks it out. I thought Walt might step into one. He's going for a layup. He was fouled.
Oh.
The way to the basket. Get you some, young fella. Get you some.
And he's letting
to
him
tie
know
the
about
game
it.
Up.
Incredible play. Looks like he slipped and didn't even really have a good chance at getting that up, but he just threw it up there, got fouled, and it came down.
Somehow he stuck with it. That's going to be the fourth foul for McKenna. McKenna scored 14 points the first half. Hasn't scored this half. For the lead. Bam. Walton with ice in his veins. Oh, man, 3:11 to go. We got a ball game here. Uh-oh, McKenna. McKenna scrambling the ball with Moore. We're going to go jump ball. And that will be a turnover. And it's going to be the Pirates' ball.
And that is my man, Derek Jackson, getting in there to force that turnover.
He's been doing it this whole half. He made a couple threes that second quarter and came out a whole different – I mean, Superman came out here.
I love a guy that – is incredible on offense, but doesn't slack on the defensive side of the ball.
I'm not aware of any phone booths in our school, but Jackson put one on, got into one, came out Superman. We're staying in this full court pressure. Brooks out there now for Pirates. Kerr out there. Walton out there. Moore out there. Jackson out there. Great drive by McKenna. His first basket of the half. And he gives him a one-point lead. Great drive by the sophomore. There goes Jackson under pressure. That's going to be a block, yep. Oh, they're going to call offensive foul on Jackson.
Wow.
Oh, man. Yeah, I got to look at that one again.
See if we get a replay here.
Man, goodness gracious. And here comes DeBond. DeBond's coming in. The ball game. He's coming in for Sauter.
They are extremely lucky there because that would have been – he would have fouled out there if that was called a blocking foul rather than a charge.
Good call there, yeah. There's Kerrigan. He just checked in. So you got DeBond, Kerrigan, and there's McKenna now up the floor. Good layup by McKenna, and he's got back-to-back baskets. Now a three-point lead. Oh, man, we're rocking.
2 minutes
when he gets
left.
To half court, there's going to be a timeout on the floor. The Pirates going to take it down by three. 2:14 to go here. And the Ralph Miller, baby, what a ball game. We're going to take a 60-second break, and we'll be right back with the finish of this ball game here on Comet Vision.
At Bridgewood Cabinetry, we believe in the power of transformation. Formerly known as Hilo Industries, our journey began right here in Chanute in 1974, where this community has been our heart and soul. We stand tall as a proud member and supporter of the Chanute community. Our success is a testament to the unwavering support of the people and businesses who live and work alongside us. Bridgewood is recognized as a technological leader in the wood products manufacturing industry, pushing boundaries every day. We are a family employing 275 dedicated individuals from Chanute and the surrounding areas, working together towards a common goal. Bridgewood provides high-quality cabinetry with cutting-edge style to over 500 kitchen and bath cabinet design studios in 48 states. This is where community and craftsmanship unite. Join us in creating spaces where memories are born and families come together. Bridgewood Cabinetry. Simple choices, endless possibilities.
We're back. You said it. Bryson, my man, said it. He said this is going to be a ball game. And that's exactly what we got with 2:14 to go. Shawnee Mission South, 3-point lead. Pipers cut into that lead a couple of times here in this quarter. And here we go, folks. On the floor for Piper is Jackson. He's going against Kerrigan. The penetration. Kerrigan's got a hand on him on the floor, and he's going to shoot two. Both teams will be shooting the rest of the way. Both teams will be in the bonus on the next foul. This one, of course, will put Piper.
And several players on both teams
got several
in foul trouble.
Yeah, buddy. This is a nice little – on the floor for Piper right now.
And that's number three's fourth.
Yeah, that's on Featherston, his third. So you got Kerr, you got Moore, you got Jackson, you got Walton, and you got Alomar Brooks on the floor for Piper. On the floor for the Raiders, you got Kerrigan, you got DeBon, you got McKenna, you got Gregory, and you got Featherston on the floor for them. So there's right now, there's Kerrigan is comes off the bench, Moore comes off the bench for Piper. We haven't seen DJ Thomas in a while, and we haven't seen Johnny Vogel, who I saw play yesterday. We haven't seen him at all. I'm going to interview the coach after this game. I want to know what's going on down there. Jackson. He makes both of them.
He has been the man at the free throw line.
He makes both of them. Brings them in to 1-point game. That pressure's still there. Trying to get in the middle of the floor.
Picked up his dribble. He's in a scary place.
Good job. He got on the sideline. Here comes DeBon to McKenna.
A little bit of a wild pass there.
Oh, almost stolen away. Almost stolen away twice. Off of them. Yeah, that's off of Gregory. Great job. That's 9 turnovers. They only had 6 in the first half. They have 9 in this half, 6 in this quarter.
Man.
So they have a chance now to take the lead. The Pirates.
Just look at that hustle on the defensive end right there.
There's Jackson being guarded by Kerrigan. Kerrigan's got a tough assignment. What's the call?
They're calling a carry?
No, they called a hook. He called a hook on Jackson. They called a hook on Jackson. And that's – God bless the officials. That's over-officiating.
I believe you were right, yes.
That's inserting yourself into the game for no reason.
2 minutes left in a 1-point game.
It's a player control foul. We're not shooting. Now, I'll go down there and help them if you want me to. You're not shooting. It's a player control foul, so you're not shooting. And that's called over-officiating. It's unfortunate. That's inserting yourself in it. And God bless his man. He's from Kansas. He's got some family around here, more than likely. Not trying to bat. That's classic over-officiating there.
I mean, every official has done it, but you just don't like to see it.
I never did either. not me. I've never been over officiate. Not me. Ooh, tipped.
Hitting the face there.
That more got him. Unintentional, but it's still a foul by Brooks. Got him.
That's a foul right there.
Oh, yeah, that's a great. That's a no-brainer.
But
we're shooting two in Kerrigan.
I mean, it's got to be the most obvious fouls in situations like this.
Piper's trying to get tips here on defense. Possible steals.
Mm-hmm. And fouls are just going to come with that.
Absolutely is going to happen.
Just
Brooks didn't mean to do that. Kerrigan goes line. This is just a freshman. The freshman at the line, bro, with ice in his veins. Extends the lead to 2.
He's had a great second half here.
Man, he has 11. Just impress these young guys. Shawnee Mission South have.
I mean,
wow. Oh, man, there you go. DeBon was not boxed out. Of all the players to box out, DeBon is the one. We're going to stay here. 1:27 to go. 4-point game here. That's unfortunate. You got Kerrigan to miss the free throw, man, and then you don't box out. the one player that we have to box out, which is DeBond. And that gives him, let's see, that's 6, 12, 14 points tonight for DeBond.
This is a very high-scoring game for us.
Yeah, all of a sudden, it just kind of became this game. We've had some moments of helter-skelter with one turnover, another turnover, one turnover, one turnover, and, you know, kind of going back and forth with not much being accomplished. But for the most part, it's been a very good offensively played ball game right now. And Derrick Jackson has really inserted himself in this ball game tonight. He has 19 tonight. And, boy, has he picked it up today, including three threes. And it's just going to be interesting to see how this game will play out. Like you said, we got several guys in some foul trouble.
Yep.
So some guys are one foul away from their night being over no matter what. And both teams are in the bonus, so we're shooting two free throws the rest of this ball game. Free throw shooting and execution is what is going to come down here for Shawnee Mission South. Pirates are going to have to be savvy. You got to be savvy. What I mean by that is you got some guys on the floor with four fouls. You don't want them committing a foul, right?
You do not.
You need some guys to know who's got four, who needs the foul, who doesn't need the foul. You want to try to get a steal if you can. You need some extra possessions. It's a two-possession ball game right now, folks. Moore being guarded by Gregory. That is a foul. Yes, it is. That is a foul by Gregory. And that's not the foul you want.
Do you got what the score is in the second half?
Oh, in the second half? Yeah, I'll give that here in just a second. You know, I got a humbled education, so I got to use all my fingers and my toes to do that for you. I'll get that here for you in a second. There's my cousin across court. My cousin over there across court. I don't know, what's he doing? He's scouting? What's he doing down here? So see what, we're going to see what Moore's got here at the line. We need him to make both of these. He's struggling a little bit here from the line. Sure, you struggle a little bit. And when you go back to Piper, they'll want to say officiating, but they've missed some bunnies and they've missed a lot of free throws tonight.
They have. I mean, they're called free throws for a reason.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Guaranteed money. That's guaranteed money. I don't know why you leave that money on the table. He missed both of them. Battle, and who are you going to give it to, ref? Who's going to go to the Pirates? Well, you talk about dodging a bullet there. Here comes Roth. He's coming in for Brooks. Roth has shown an ability. I watched a couple games. He's shown an ability to be able to shoot the three when needed. That may be why they're bringing him in. There's Kerr. Kerr gets a tough shot on DeBond. That's it for DeBond. Wowzers. I think that will be it for him. That'll put Kerr on the line to shoot, too.
That's huge.
Oh, that is huge. And that's tough. Hats off to that young man. Just a sophomore himself. Boy, he played some spirited basketball today.
Back into the lineup for Piper.
He finishes with 14. And you know what? This Shawnee Mission South. Next year, bruh, they're going to be a force to be. These kids are, I mean, March, they're going to be a force to contend with by March. Just how well they play this game. But boy, you look a year ahead, man. There's good things to look ahead to. And another free throw miss from the Pirates. Another free throw miss from the Pirates. Wowzers. Wowzers. Ooh, he missed both. Don't call a foul there on Moore. Rebound by Kerrigan. I think that's his fourth.
Pirates PJ Moore.
So Kerrigan gets to shoot two. I told you it's going to come down to free throw shooting.
I mean, it is.
Free throw shooting and execution in the fourth quarter. So much of the game at this point is mental toughness. Having guys who are just mentally tough enough to do what it takes. Kerrigan, as a freshman, goes to that line and shows that mental toughness. Roth and Brooks got this offense-defense thing going on, so Roth checks back in for Pirates.
And that's really been the difference here. He sinks this. Yeah, that puts them up by six.
It's still a two-possession ball game, but makes it really tough, especially with no shot clock. 106 to go. There's Brooks. He's going to penetrate. Out to Jackson. He can hit that. Top of the key. He does.
Knocks it down.
Jackson does.
Timeout called by Piper.
That's his third three of this ball game. Timeout on the floor, Piper. Which one did they take? That's what they're taking. They're taking a full timeout. We're taking a 30-second timeout here. 58 seconds to go in the fourth. 64-61, the 52nd annual Rob Miller Classic here on Comet Vision.
Coffee House is dedicated to high school and college students. Our mission is for every student in Southeast Kansas to know they have value, they are loved, and that they have a place. We are not a church, but we are motivated by the love God has for all of us. The Fire Escape opened in 1998 and is open every Friday and Saturday night for high school and college-age students. During the week, the Fire Escape is open to the public Tuesday through Friday mornings for coffee, catch-ups, or small groups like Bible studies. The Fire Escape Coffee House is proud to partner with the Chanute High School Tech Classes on this broadcast.
25-9.
Wow.
That's what we're looking at here in this fourth quarter. Piper has tried to weather the storm. Down by three. They were down by 11.
Down to a three-point game.
Here's Featherston.
Impressive.
Good job there by – that's a good job there by Brooks.
Foul is charged to Elmar Brooks. His fourth personal foul.
Roth and Brooks are doing this offense-defense thing here.
And the dangerous thing here is that the Piper does not have the bench depth that the
Ben Vogel, man. He missed
the
it.
The Raiders have.
Sodder missed it. So you got to find Jackson early. If you're Shiny Mission South, you've got to find Jackson. Early.
You need to box out.
Don't wait to half court to find this kid. Find him early.
He misses both.
Okay, here comes Jackson.
He gets the ball himself.
Here comes Jackson. I would have picked him up earlier than that. I would have picked him up a long time ago. They should have picked him up earlier than that. That's too much. I'm trying to tell y'all what I know. It's a one-point game, folks. It's a one-point game. Ooh, almost thrown away. McKenna skies up and gets that ball. Ooh, 10 seconds.
Timeout.
Good timeout by Shawnee Mission. We're going to stay here. We're going to stay right here. There's no reason for us to leave you now with 33 seconds to go in a one-point ball game. South is going to call their timeout. That's a timeout by Shawnee Mission South on the floor. Oh, man. So what are you drawing now if you're the coach of Shawnee Mission South? What are you drawing up here?
I think they need to – they're going to pass the ball in probably here at midcourt. They need to – kick the ball back into the backcourt. Try to waste as much time as possible. Get fouled. And what we've been saying this whole time, knock down the free throws.
I'm telling my kids, if I'm trying to miss myself, don't expect and don't anticipate a whistle. So many kids want the refs to bail them out. You got to want to win this game. We've got to secure the ball with both hands. We don't know if they're going to call a foul.
No.
So just because somebody – I don't want you – trying to fall down, trying to help the official, make them knock you down to get the basketball. So, one, you want to secure that basketball. You want to be strong with the basketball. Shawnee Mission South, if you're the Piper Pirates, listen, ball hawking. Now, also, don't be surprised if Shawnee Mission South tries to throw over the top of this press and get somebody going to the basket. Don't be surprised. Mm-hmm. This is a very well coached, Shawnee Mission South, very well coached. I just think sometimes you can become so cautious with the lead to a fault. And so don't be surprised if they try to get somebody to go to the basket and try to get the ball to them. Mm-hmm. Keach, Kerrigan, McKenna, Gregory, Featherston all in the game for the Shawnee Mission South.
See, they're not even going to put the ball on the floor, it looks like.
Featherston there. Over to Kerrigan.
Someone's got a foul.
Yep, they foul. Gregory.
19 seconds left. Two free throws here. These are monumental free throws.
Telling me. Still a one. No matter what, it's going to be a one-possession ball game. I mean, you got enough speed on Piper. You don't have to force three. You have enough speed on Piper's team to get down the floor and get a quick layup and try it again.
And you've got a guy, Derek Jackson, who has that ice in his veins.
Boy, Gregory.
Got
those
that dog in him, whatever you
want
to say.
Yeah, but Gregory, strong grown man free throws. Roth. Brooks exchange here, offense, defense.
Now, I'm going to say it again, if they need to box out. They've been in a situation like this before, and they let Shawnee Mission get
Pirates
the rebound.
You have Moore, you have Walton, and you have Jackson, all capable of hitting threes. But you also have guys can get quick layups. Here comes Moore. He may get a quick layup here. Moore turns the corner, told you. Off the glass,
wow.
Good. Told you.
Athletic layup.
Told you. See, 13 seconds, 3 seconds. And a lot of kids don't understand this about the game, bro. 16 seconds is eternity in basketball. Mm-hmm. It doesn't take much time. That's a great job by Moore. We call it time and possession. That's what you call that in basketball. You got to know how much time is on the clock. You got to understand the possessions.
Yeah.
And that's the kid that watches the game.
He does.
You understand what I'm saying? That's the kid that watches the game. Great job by Moore. He has 9 tonight for the Pirates here of Piper. Good ball game, folks, here. 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic. First game tonight. Good ball game.
We got 60, one 60, more 60, game 60. Ahead.
Yeah, man. You're right. We get to eat some more after this.
I've seen a lot of basketball in my life, and this is up there with some of the most entertaining ball I've ever seen.
Very entertaining basketball game. Yeah, this is red beans and cornbread tonight, baby. We eating good tonight. Red beans and cornbread out there tonight. Now, we got on the floor for the Shawnee Mission. We got McKenna. We got Gregory, Featherston, Keach, Kerrigan, Moore for Pirates, Walton, Jackson.
They can't have Kerr foul.
Ooh, Jackson does foul. Good job.
I think he's the one player on the floor who doesn't already have four fouls.
If you're the Raiders, you got to make both of these, please. You got to make both of these. Jackson gets his fourth. There's McKenna. McKenna's had two big baskets in this fourth quarter. He has 18 tonight. He had 14 in the first half. Just a sophomore. Deep breath. He eyes it. Tries it. It's good. Roth and Brooks do their exchange again.
It looks like, yep, Roth coming in. Possibly as another man to just get a foul.
Well, they're doing offense-defense with him. So they're Roth and Brooks are exchanging offense-defense. Oh, man. Big, big shot here by McKenna. It's up, and it's good. Man,
9 seconds
that's
left.
That's impressive. Here comes Jackson. Three-point ball game. 5. Screen set for Jackson. Turns the corner. Loses control of the ball. Jackson, long 2.
Oh, man.
Jackson didn't know what to do. Just didn't run the play down the stretch.
Nope.
Oh, man, lost his head.
Great defense there.
Great defense. Absolutely. And that's how we'll finish here tonight in the very first game. Shawnee Mission South pulls it out 68-65 off of 14 from DeBon. And looks like 20 from McKenna. Mm-hmm. Another big game for Kerrigan, too, man. Kerrigan had 13 also for Shawnee Mission South Raiders. And for the Pirates, Derek Jackson had a good ball game. Just didn't get it.
I think 100% the only reason that Piper lost is how much they struggled at the free throw line.
Free throw line and the bunnies.
And the layups that they had just right under the basket and missed.
I agree with you. Well, that'll do it in the first game. Getting ready for that second one. Andover Central's on the floor, and your beloved Chanute Blue Comets coming up here in the second game. So stay locked here at the 52nd annual Ralph Miller Classic.